Well, luckily, I didn't have to persuade them at all to work with me. I was very lucky. It was a very smooth process for all the collaborations on the album. Logistically speaking, you know, Jeff, who runs the label, kind of gave me the opportunity to do the album. You know, the wish list was constructed. The wish list went to Jeff. Phone calls got made, and there's no kind of like insanely dramatic storyline. It literally was that simple. I had an idea of how I wanted it to sound, dynamically and musically, and it was great to be able to have the opportunity to do that rather than kind of stick to your 16 bars of beats, you know, breakdown, outro beats, you know, DJ friendly stuff. It was nice just to go, you know, just see what happens, just go with the flow and see what goes down. Well, I think possibly the most enjoyable session, just purely because it was almost the most surreal thing ever, was when Jocelyn Brown, I'd already been up to London, we kind of done the preliminary sort of rehearsal with the boat and everything, we're all happy. So she came down to me. At the time I was living in the centre of Chichester, a little two bedroom flat. You know, the album really was born out of a bedroom studio. And that was the most bizarre thing, is that Jocelyn Brown came down to my flat and sat in my bedroom and recorded Worthy. And it was just very, very weird. This incredible musician and artist had come down to my humble little dwelling and sang the foundations off my place. It was great, loved it. I think the track that makes me smile every time I listen to it, purely probably because of the message more than anything, and that's In Time. You know, it's you know, life can get pretty crappy, you know, along the journey, and it basically just saying, you know, just ride out the bumps, it'll sort itself out eventually, kind of thing. Yes, yeah, there was no two ways about it, really. You know, when I was, you know, asked and engaged to make this album, because I'd obviously was working quite heavily within the house music industry, I was remixing a lot, I was producing a lot. You know, I really wanted this album to showcase more about me as a musician and producer than just dance music. Definitely. Just purely because of the, I suppose, the aspirations we had for what the end result was going to be. And I was very used to making records for club and DJs. So I had to sort of retrain myself almost to write and produce the way I used to, which was not have to worry about whether someone's going to mix it in or not. You know, it was sort of being a lot more, being a lot tighter in the writing process in terms of the structure of the songs and stuff like that. You know, I didn't have to waffle on for ages and ages with some lead sound and then followed by a breakdown, isn't it? Because, you know, that's, to me, that's what I didn't want to happen with the album. I've got the bug now. Now that I've done one album, hopefully it's fulfilled, you know, my criteria in terms of, you know, it's creative, it's dynamics, all that kind of stuff. So hopefully there'll be many, many more albums. Whether it's in my neighbour's back garden or at Wembley Arena, we don't really care. Anywhere in between would be great. We're just going to start sort of, you know, pinning in some dates. And if we can just get one really cool live show in a month. Obviously the DJing thing goes on top of that, and various PAs and all that kind of thing. So it's a busy time ahead. Hi, my name is Richard Earnshaw, and I want to get up to date on all the dance and soul music news. I read soulm8 e-zine.